A desperate move. That's how one political analyst describes the joint press conference held by presidential candidates Isko Moreno, Panfilo Lacson, and Norberto Gonzalez on Sunday. Professor Aris Arugay says what occurred was a clear character assassination of Vice President Leni Robredo. He warns negative campaigning usually backfires on those behind it.
Nasabi na yung mensahe, hindi na kahit may disclaimer in the end na ibahagi na yung mensahe that they were there really to sabotage the campaign of Vice President Robredo. Wag na tayo magpaligoy-ligoy. Yung po yung mensahe, no? So kahit anong gawing spin nila sa kakahilo, mahilo man sila o hindi, no? Yung po yung lumalabas na mensahe po ng press con kahapon. All the others, the call for clean elections, the call for people being given a choice, nabura na po yun. Aminin na po natin ang katotohanan. Ang lumalabas po kahapon, pinupuntirya po ng mga kalalakihang kandidato ang nangungunang babaeng kandidato sa halalan na.
Arugay adds, there were also some misinformation that came out of the press con that need to be clarified.
Yung komento na sinabi ni VPL magkakagulo pag hindi siya nanalo. Actually, yung mga nagagaslight na magkakagulo are the candidates who were in the press con. Yung po yung may resibo, sila mismo yung nagsabi na magkakakudeta at sinabi yung isa magkakadestabilization kung manalo si yung frontrunner, no?
Philippine Vice President Leni Robredo, unfazed by calls of her rivals for her to withdraw from the race to Malacañang. She's back at the campaign trail wooing voters in Infanta, Quezon after the Holy Week break. She continues to urge her supporters to shun the noise and focus on campaigning instead with just 3 weeks to go before the May 9 elections. She also calls on them to show Filipinos what true unity means.
Yung nakaraan, mas marami yung tahimik, pero bakit ngayon lumalaban? Dahil naiintindihan natin na yung election na to hindi na lang tungkol sa aming mga kandidato. Na yung election na to, ang pipiliin na natin, kandidato ba o bayan? Pinag-uusapan lagi pagkakaisa. Pero ang tunay na pagkakaisa, ito yon. Ang tunay na pagkakaisa ng mga tao. Ang tunay na pagkakaisa para proteksyonan yung interes ng ating bansa. Hindi para proteksyonan ang mga politiko. Papasalamat sa inyong pagtsatsaga ngayon. Nagpapasalamat po kami sa suportang binibigay ninyo ngayon.
On Sunday, Robredo's rivals, Senator Ping Lacson, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, and former Defense Chief Norberto Gonzalez held a press conference where the Vice President was urged to back out from the race. They claim they have a better shot at defeating frontrunner Bongbong Marcos, even if they're trailing behind Robredo in recent surveys.
Kung meron mang supreme sacrifice, yung number two should do and start initiating the supreme sacrifice. Let Leni withdraw. Withdraw Leni. I'm calling for Leni to withdraw. Kasi whatever you're doing is not effective against the Marcos. Withdraw, come and join us. Join us. Pwede pasab. Pasab naman. Baka kami maka 3 points.
Eh kung talaga po natin gustong talunin yung number one, eh baka dapat po palitan natin yung player natin sa number two.
Na-echapuero yung ibang choices, yung ibang options. And that is also one of the main reasons why we are here. No, to remind our people that there are other candidates running, equally qualified, equally competent, if not more competent.
Members of Vice President Leni Robredo's senatorial slate come out in full force following calls for her to abandon her presidential bid. Former Ifugao Representative Teddy Bagilat says it's rare for a candidate to withdraw. He also urged others to acknowledge Robredo's growing number of supporters. Former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV revealed he tried to stop unification talks between anti-administration forces due to differences between the bets that were seemingly evident in Sunday's press conference. He adds the house-to-house campaigns being conducted by volunteers of the Robredo-Pangilinan tandem have become the real face of unity this campaign period. Senator Laila De Lima, for her part, said it is not Robredo's fault that other campaigns are suffering setbacks. Attorney Chel Diokno seemingly took a swipe at the politicians present at Sunday's press conference by calling them poor cowboys. As for presidential candidate Leody De Guzman, he poked fun at the press conference and highlighted the fact that it happened at a luxury hotel. Senator Ping Lacson, meanwhile, clarifies he is not echoing Mayor Moreno's call for Vice President Robredo to withdraw from the presidential race. Lacson's spokesman adds the calls for withdrawal should not even be the key takeaway following Sunday's press conference.
Kumbaga nagsangasanga na ang mga kwento at mga pangyayari kahapon. But that said, I guess it is incumbent upon all of them and even me who represent one of the candidates yesterday to reiterate what really was the big, should be the bigger message. We must remember ang being portrayed right now is this is just a fight between the one and the two. Well, that is unfortunate, no? Precisely why the candidates reiterated yesterday na they still have other choices.
The camp of Manila Mayor Isko Moreno believes they benefited from the outcome of Sunday's press conference. The head of Moreno's campaign volunteer team says the press conference did exactly what they hoped it would do. To clarify, they are staying in the presidential race despite calls to back out. He also insists the call for Robredo to withdraw from the race was not misogynistic.
There was no gender issue involved. As our mayor said, their issue was based on what they perceive as character or a character flaw in asking them to withdraw. And then when we ask the same things, we are pilloried for saying basically the same thing. We would have made the same statement if it were Senator Marcos who asked us to withdraw.
Former supporters of Isko Moreno calling out the Manila mayor and other presidential aspirants for attacking Robredo. In a statement, former MMDA General Manager Tim Orbos and other key members of Ikaw Muna Pilipinas expressed their disappointment over what they branded as vindictive machismo. They also accused the male bets of unwittingly becoming the greatest allies of Marcos. But Moreno's political party is dismissing their criticism.
They portrayed the vice president as a lady with no way to defend herself. Come on. Hindi naman batang paslit po si vice presidente. Kita mo naman yung drama na ginagawa nila rito. Now they're saying na nag-benefit si Bongbong Marcos. No, I don't think so. They could say it all they want because they are already with the vice president's camp.
Last week, regional chapters of IM Pilipinas shifted their allegiance from Moreno to Robredo. But the group's acting secretary general said majority of their members are staying with the Manila mayor.